Hello, this is the RPG Check. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I was starting to do all this stuff off screen, like sleep and stuff like that, and I wanted to look at my library books.
Sure.
See what has to be read, what we have in the library that we haven't come across. But when I woke up from sleeping, let's see if it happens again. I didn't even read the thing, I just reloaded. Adair woke us up. Woodland Trails bonus. Half asleep, a tide of deafening whispers assails you, chipping away at your senses, at your mind's understanding of itself. Their roar is louder with each passing night, their attacks more brazen, less confined to your subconscious. A familiar voice fights its way through the din, calling out to you.
Hey! Hey! You gotta stop it with that. I just about punched you to snap you out of it. You were saying things, but they weren't any words I ever heard. You were shaking so hard I thought you'd crack your spine.
What happened to the bucket of cold water? Adair shrugs and looks away, concealing his smile poorly. What would I do without a friend to punch me?
Well, it's nice to feel needed. I'd evoke you sooner, but I thought it'd be nice for you to be able to close your eyes a bit. Folks don't last long without sleep. You're twitchy these days. Reminds me of Meyerwald more than I'd like. And anything I can do, you just let me know. We're close on this one. Hang on a little longer. We'll get you fixed up.
Appreciate it, friend. And I see he wants to talk as well. And something's going on here. Glamfellen Soul Hunter has arrived. But expensive. Sure, why not?
Say what you want about Dear Woodens, but they haven't met the problem yet that they couldn't solve by killing some scapegoats.
He flashes a hollow smile. You fight for people because you see something there that deserves defending, even more so because someone you trust sees it too. Then you turn around and they do something like this, and the person who made you want to help them is gone. They're doing what they think the gods want of them. It's nice that they mean well, but how can organized murder be their best guess? Although, come to think of it, maybe they're just following Widewind's example. He was purging his own long before Deerwood got the idea. Only he was purging because they weren't Eothasian enough. Never thought I'd find myself missing the hospitality back home. That's what he wanted to say. Okay. Everybody? I wonder if our stewardess would have anything to say. My lady, I have heard terrible things. I worried you would not return. Is it true that there are riots in Defiance Bay? And that Avar Wolfgrin has been slain? Yes, and I'll make Theos pay for what he's done. I am sure you will, my lady, and much does he deserve it. May the gods harry his every step. I am glad, after all, that you are unharmed. I can only hope that Defiance Bay recovers. Alright, let's head up to the library. Okay, off screen, I'm gonna check out all these books. see what we might have and what we don't. And whatever we don't, I'll read. Okay, I've been over all these books, and believe it or not, we have read all of them except for Admeth Hadret, Volume 2. I read Volume 1 previously. And the Deerwood books past 2. The Deerwood Volume 3 is not in here. Where exactly it is, it's... The Deerwood Part 1. Which one are we looking at? The Deerwood Part 2. It's not in any of these. The Deerwood Part 4. 5. And 6. I'd love to read them, but where the hell is 3? And I was thinking, well, maybe the center with all the books, I can't remember the name of it, guys, where they want to kill us. We have bad standing with them right now. Maybe they have the book, but we can't even get into Defiance Bay right now to look, because it's all closed down because of the riots and stuff. So I'm going to read Admeth Hadret Part 1 and 2. Part 1 I know I'm reading again, but at least this way I can read them both in a row. And then I'm going to go on my way. So, bear with me a second while I find out which one it is. There's the Deerwood book. See, I have 1. And 5. And 6. And I'm pretty sure I had 2. I don't know what happened. I might have sold some by mistake. And the Adir Empire is 1 and 2. There's no volumes in here past 2, and I've read them both, so... I thought we were going to come across a lot of new books that we haven't seen, but nope. Okay, this is Admeth Hadret Part 2. It's a brownish book. That's the first one. They fixed the windows, too. They were not as wide as this. Admeth Hadret Part 1, Rise to Power. Little could one know that the man who once destroyed part of his own country with fire would become the Deerwood's most beloved leader. Martyred in the war he started to free his people from an oppressive rule, there isn't a Deerwooden who doesn't know of or revere Admeth for what he did. Strangely, even though there are records of his father Edrang's childhood, and even though he was raised in nobility in the Deerwood, while it was still Adir territory, information about Admeth's early years is nearly impossible to find. Admeth is not known for his childhood, though. He is known for saving the Deerwood and uniting it with its sworn enemy, the Glamfellens. In 2652 AI, the Deerwooden troubles with their fair coning were at a boiling point. Several of the earls under Edrang's rule, provoked by the imperial court in Adir, resumed looting the ruins around Deerwood that the Glamfellens held sacred. When the Glamfellens finally retaliated, it was overwhelmingly brutal and resulted in a slave uprising. Galvin Regid, whom Edrang had fought before, resumed control of the Glamfellen troops. Regid was also able to convince some Dilemgin to join the fight. Edrang was, at this point, far too old to lead his forces into battle, so he sent his son Admeth in his place to contain the threat. Admeth, true to form as the son of Edrang, and obviously having learned tactics from his father, made a dangerous but effective tactical decision. In order to prevent Regid's troops from using the woods as cover and to keep them from advancing through his land, set fire to the forest at tributary of the Ist-Uar River and positioned his troops to prevent any of the Glanfathan forces from retreating. This tactic proved to be effective. While some Glanfathans and Dalemgan were able to escape, thousands died. In the skirmish that followed, Galvin Regid was captured and sent to be held at New Haymar. Admeth was able to do what his father spent decades trying to do. He stopped Galvin Regid. The conflict with the Glanfathans continued for several months, and Admeth repeated the scorched earth tactic several times to flush the opposing forces from key battlefields. He was able to bring the conflict to an end before the year ended. While it was a win for the Deerwoodens, it was very costly as well. Because of his tactics, the conflict earned the name the War of Black Trees. After Edrang's death in 2654, Admeth became the Greff of the Deerwood, to the dismay of the Imperial Court and the other earls. Over the course of the next year, they defied his rule at every turn, rebuking his decrees and countermanding his directives. In 2655 AI, Admeth had had enough. Even though he lacked support from most of the earls, he was admired by both the Valian dukes and all the common folk. Backed by the support, he issued an ultimatum to the Faerconing to anoint him a Greff Palatine. The Faerconing, unwilling to deal with a rebellion while trying to establish a new Vorlas trade in Red Saris, agreed. Admeth then held authority and legal power over the earls, their holdings, and their titles. The Deerwood was no longer a Greffrum, but instead was a Palatinate. This change reduced the Faerconing's power over the region. With his new power, Admeth quickly brought the rebellious earls into line. But, in exchange for the power, Admeth invested time and money into all of the Deerwood's ports and trade posts, dramatically increasing shipping traffic. This helped the earls and brought in more money for the Faerconing. Okay. And Admeth Hadret, Part 2. Rebellion. Over the 5 years following his ascension to Greff, Admeth attempted to mend relations with the Glanfathans and bring his land together with theirs. He enacted laws that restricted the taking of new slaves, allowed Glanfathans to buy their fellows out of bondage, and imposed a tax on slave ownership in order to promote the use of free labor. While there was some resistance to these new laws, the Faerconing's attention to Red Saris and Admeth's power, backed by the colonists, made it difficult for the earls to truly resist what was happening. In 2662 AI, in the year of the 10th anniversary of the War of Black Trees, Admeth brought about an end to the slavery in the Deerwood. He negotiated a series of treaties with the Glanfathans, wherein a timeline was established for the official emancipation of all remaining slaves. Each owner would receive compensation in either land or money based on the number of slaves freed. If they didn't comply, the slaves would be seized and their former masters would suffer a substantial fine. In return for this, the Glanfathans opened trade routes with the Deerwood and allowed Deerwoodens to live in and near areas that had their sacred ruins, but they are under no conditions to enter the ruins. As a final act of goodwill, Admeth freed Galvin Regid, saying that he had suffered sufficiently for his actions. The Faerconing, seeing he was completely out of control in his own Palatinate, devised a plan to get the supply of ancient artifacts running again. He approached the earls suffering under Admeth's rule and convinced them to hire agents to raid the ruins. Initially, they did so in secret, but they quickly became sloppy, eventually being caught. The breach of the treaties incited Glanfathans again to acts of violence while Admeth researched who was behind it. With help of the Glanfathan leaders, Admeth found evidence that pointed back to the Faerconing as the source of the raids. That was the beginning of the end for Adirin rule in the Deerwood. Over the next 7 years, Admeth and the Faerconing maneuvered around each other, playing political, economic, and military games in order to gain the upper hand. In 2668 AI, Admeth declared the Deerwood had had enough. The Faerconing would no longer be recognized. The Deerwood was now a free entity and would govern itself. This started the War of Defiance, which lasted 5 years. The end result of the war was freedom for the Deerwood, and though Duke Hadret would never live to see it come to a close, the people of Deerwood consider him the founder of the country, nevertheless. All right. So that's those two.
Hmm.
And at some point we will find, I hope, the Deerwood Volume 3. And then I can read all those. I'll probably make a separate video reading all of them. There's six of them. Alright, let's get out of here. This Pearlwood Bluff. We've never been here, have we? I'm curious. I don't remember that one. Yeah, we've never been here. Quest updated for the Long Hunt. We should go back and get her. The towers are done. This stuff wasn't here before, was it? I actually want to go back here and look. East and west. West Curtain Wall. I swear they're adding them. We already have the Warden's Lodge. What? Hold on. Alright, I've encountered a bug. The Warden's Lodge has been undone. My stuff is being undone. I'm not happy. How many times do I have to pay to get this stuff done and then wait? That was done. I know we didn't do the Forum Chapel or Artificer's Hall or the Craft Hall. West Curtain Wall, I thought was done. I guess that's Western Barbican is different, but I guess next we should do that. That hand is gonna crush that house. Alright. Now we should bring Sagani with us. We'll leave Kanna behind for this one.
Safe travels.
Mm-hmm. They should say something when you recruit them too, like, yay! I finally get to come with you. Dunreed Sion has arrived seeking employment. But my patrols intervened. Sure, why not? Okay, so Sagani's with us.
Nice and quiet.
Nice and quiet, like.
Do these look like the cliffs from your vision?
Not answering. Oh, she can level up. Yeah, she's a little behind us. She's got high survival. She's a ranger. Swift aim. Takedown for the animal companion. 2 per encounter. Nice. Takedown. Oh, she leveled up again. Cool, she's just leveling, like, to match us, I guess. Accurate wounding shot. Brutal takedown. Ah. 23 crush damage when they take it down. Resilient companion. Plus 5 damage. Merciless companion. I'm gonna take brutal takedown. And now she's level 9. Awesome. Got her athletics way up there. Finding roots. Cool. Arrow sense. Plus 15 deflection against ranged attacks. Go take that. She's leveled up to match us. I like it. Alright. I'm not sure if this was always here. Just grab this. Or if it just opened up with Act 3. The rest spell. Zorb champion. I think we're all mixed up here. Attack. Oh boy, a whole bunch. Priest and skirmisher as well.
Dead on!
And a drake? Okay. And a skirmisher, and a skirmisher. And another champion. Alright. This is gonna be a little tough. Let's see if I can do a puppet master on what the skirmisher. Or one of them. Try that. I'm gonna let us concussive missiles on the drake. We're gonna try to take down this drake first. Holy Radiance. Oh, I gotta switch everyone back. Knockdown. Flaming Sword. Mark to Prey. Takedown. Alright, move up. So you can do this. Barely injured. Huh. Still has yet to cast. Oh, he's about to cast it, I guess? Yeah, it's Aloth. Blessing. Another concussive missile. Knock him down again. The guy's really messed up. I don't know if she ever cast that spell. She's still working on it. Okay, she's about to cast it.
Yep. And mowing.
Oh, the wolf's down. Wounding shot. Boom. Now did she cast a spell? Did it work? Dominated for 13.5 seconds. I don't know where he is. He might have wore off already, I don't know. You have a 5 thrust off of a dare. Fireball. Shield.
I'm here.
Don't bother getting up. Is he what? Well, he's in frightened mode. Badly injured, knocked it to the ground again. I guess that was a dare, right? Clear out mode.
Hey.
I should have waited till it got up. Healing.
What?
A little bit. Yeah. Soul ignition for you. Just for you. Because we care. Excellent. Now we can just pick off these guys one by one.
Lava, be on seat!
Cool. Hell with it. Oh boy. She's gonna cast it. All right. I really didn't even care about disengaging, I'm like, just kill him.
If we-
Ooh. Yes, yes, enough. Alright, some Valoons, Parado, some Aedra, tongues and claws and fun stuff like that.
Sure.
Anything else? Did we miss anything? Yeah, the wolf's standing on it. Can you move, please? Thank you.
Ready, Watcher.
I like that. Ready, Watcher. Look at all that Adra. Did I say Adra again before? I meant Adra.
No problem.
Ain't got a problem. Alright. It's not a very big zone. Seem to be clearing out the fog of war very quickly. Admeth's wort. Vass is lost. This might have something to do with her quest. Oh, I'm not going down yet. A lively breeze ruffles your clothes as you approach the edge of the bluff. A cave mouth yawns from the cliff face. It's only a dozen feet below your position, but the weathered rock is too smooth to scale. A rock perches near the precipice. It feels like a sturdy anchor. Not going down yet. I'm going to finish exploring the zone. I'm going to call it an episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time. I hear banging. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Ooh! We'll fight him next episode. Forest Lurker. I heard him stomping around over there. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong.